This is how to play Mumford and Sons' Little La Nan on guitar. Start with the tuning. I've got Capo on the 5th fret. My first string plays an F. My second string plays a D. My third string plays another F. My fourth string plays a C. My fifth string plays another F. And my last string plays an A. To give, which is an open F6 tuning. Start with the intro, which goes like this. We'll start with the chords in the strumming of the intro. And the first chord is a D minor chord, which is the first 5 strings played with your middle finger on the 2nd fret of the 4th string to give. Muting the 1st string with your thumb to give. And then the 2nd chord is the F major chord with your 3rd finger on the 3rd fret of the 2nd string to give this. Playing all strings. The strumming starts with an upbeat, so if you're counting in the metre of 4-4, we'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. So it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Keep repeating that over, slow it down until you get a feel of when the upbeat comes onto the first beat. The strumming starts on the first beat of after the upbeat, and we're playing palm muted. And the strumming pattern goes down, down, up, down, 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 up, down, down, down. And on the first and the only up, you wanna take your hand off the strings for palm mute, and you want to make it open for very briefly. So you have down, down, open, down, down, open, down, down, open, down, down. To stead up and in neater, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Keep practicing that over and over and slowing it down until you get a feel of the neater and the strumming. We then play the 2nd chord, which is the F major chord, and we play the strumming pattern down, down, up, down, 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 down. Down, 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 up, down, 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 down. On the 3rd beat, we use our middle finger on the 2nd fret of the 4th and 3rd string to play. So if we're playing by the neater, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. After you've played the, we stay on that chord and we play the following strumming pattern of down, down, up, down, 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 up, down, 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 up, down, down, down. And you'll know if you're playing on the meter or not. If every time you get on the 1st and 3rd beat, you're playing the bass note of F, the 1st string. You're playing that on the 1st and 3rd beat. So you're going 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Slowing it down and using the 1st and 2nd chord that we just showed, it should sound like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. The 2nd part to the intro goes like this. With a hammer on to the 2nd fret of that D minor chord. And it's played like this. And then we repeat what we just did with the previous chord again. We move on to the verse, which uses the same chords as the intro and the same strumming pattern as well until the later on. So we have down, down, up, down, 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 down, down. Only difference about the verse is that it has different chords in it towards the end. And when that happens, we move up to the 7th fret. And we use our 1st finger on the 7th fret of the 1st string. And then we put our middle finger on the 2nd string and on the 10th fret to give the same note. And that's played with the same strumming pattern for a bar, and then it moves down 2 frets to the 5th fret, and then it moves down to the 2nd fret for one last 2 beats, and then moves back down to the F major chord. And then it's repeated again until you move into the chorus. The chorus is pretty simple to play in the first bit, and it's pretty simple to play when it's played again later on. In the first bit, it's just played open chords. Playing three chords there, playing the D minor chord, and then we're playing the chord that we played in the verse on the fifth fret, and then we're moving that down to the F major chord. And when it gets on to Didn't Know an Idea, we move up to the seventh fret to play. Playing the same strumming pattern in the verse, down, down, up, down, 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 up, down, down. And then we move on to the chorus into the second verse. The chorus into the second verse is quite easy again. It's the same strumming pattern in the verse, but except we're not palm muting, we're playing open. Down, down, up, down, 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 down, down. And we're playing that twice until we move on to the second verse. The second verse is exactly the same as the first verse, except for towards the end. Instead of keeping it all palm muted, Marcus starts playing the chords open instead of being it palm muted. And that's after we first play the 7th and 5th and 2nd fret chords. So after we played that sequence of... And as soon as we return to that F chord, we start bringing it more open. So we go... Play that same sequence again, but open. Accenting when we play each chord. And it's the same strumming as it has been throughout. Like the chorus into the second verse, it's the exact same strumming pattern open, but except we're playing the same chords in the first chorus. So it would be the first chorus goes... Except now we're playing it like the chorus into the second verse, open. So it's exactly the same, but you're just playing it with the same strumming pattern open as the chorus into the second verse. Now the second chorus into the bridge and the bridge itself, we'll do it together. Is really simple. It's just doing going alternating between the D minor chord and the F major chord, but just going. It's like playing, but you're only playing the upstrokes. So you're going. The bridge itself is really simple as well. It's not like the strumming pattern, which you might have found difficult before. It's simple, just down strokes. And to play the bridge, we have the F major chord, but then we get our first finger and we put it on the second fret of the third string to give us... And except this, all of this bit is muted, it's palm muted, and just down strokes strumming. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. After playing that for a couple of bars, we get our third or fourth finger on the third fret. It's not third fret, it's fourth fret. After playing that for a couple of bars, we get our third or fourth finger and put it on the fourth fret of the third string to play that. Bearing in mind, we're playing all strings. Then after a couple of bars of playing that, we get our middle finger and we put it on the 8th fret, not the 7th, the 8th fret of the 2nd string. And then we repeat that, I don't know how many times it is, like 3 times, I don't know. When this bit changes, it doesn't become muted anymore and it becomes like the same strumming pattern as we saw in the intro and the verse. So it goes... And then it's the chorus played again. Same strumming pattern, everything is the same, and then that's pretty much it. Hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you have any questions or anything, just comment below or inbox me or something. But yeah, if you have any questions, just let me know, and I hope you enjoyed. Cheers.